Hi everyone, hope you're doing amazing today. We're doing really well, thank you. My name is Carolina Fonseca Jimenez. I focus on doing children's books that promote love, unity, and peace. And as many of you know, we talk about dreams here. The reason that we do that is because when we talk about our dreams, we are connecting with one another on a more profound level. But also, we interpret our individual dreams because when we do that, we're connecting with our subconscious on a very, very deep level. So, okay guys, as you know, I am back from Mexico. It was a magical trip. It was amazing. And then now that we're back, I'm like, okay, so what are we going to talk about this week? What is the message for the week about our dream interpretations? So what I found was that I've gotten a lot of messages from you about dream interpretation, but not for you specifically, but for your children. So I found that kind of interesting. And then I had a dream last night that confirmed that that was the topic for today. So, okay, guys, we're going to talk about that. What does it mean when a child is dreaming? How do we interpret those dreams? And why are they so important for us to even pay attention to? Okay, so before we get into that topic, though, I want to do a little shout out to a couple of kids that I met in Mexico. As you know, we were sharing our book of Lupita and the Magic of Mexico. And while we were doing that, we met some really great kids, and a few of them became a very good friends of ours. So I want to send a shout out to Kevin from Leon, Guanajuato. I hope you're doing amazing. It was wonderful to meet you and your little friend, and I'm sure I'll be seeing you soon when we do our book reading at your school. So I'm really excited. Brenda from San Miguel de Allende. Brenda, happy birthday. I know you are celebrating your birthday this weekend. I send you a big hug and a big shout out to you and your family, okay? All right, guys, so right, now that we're back, let's go ahead and just get into our topic. What do we do when a child is telling us about their dream? How do we help them interpret it, and why is it so important, okay? So the first thing we want to do is remember that when a child or when anyone is telling us their dream, we have to remember that they are literally sharing something with us that is at their most profound level, that is at their deepest subconscious. So we want to be very respectful of what they're telling us. And when a child is telling you their dreams, sometimes those dreams are going to be more vivid, more creative. Sometimes they're going to sound even a little weird, off the wall to you, right? But remember, let's take a step back. Let's remember to just accept the dream and not judge it. Let's just accept it and allow the child to really tell us what is going on with their dream. Because when they're telling us this, we want to make sure that we're listening to all of the information that they are able to provide us, okay? After you listen to the dream, the next thing you want to do is ask them the question, right? The main question that we always ask whenever anybody tells us the dream. And what is that? It's, what were you feeling during the dream, okay? Because what they're feeling, guys, that is the key. Just like it's the key for the adults, it's the same thing for the children. We wanna know what it is that they're feeling during this dream. If they're feeling happy, if they're feeling joyful, if they're feeling excited, those are all wonderful feelings that we want to keep encouraging. So that just lets us know, okay, we're on the right path, things are going well, that's fantastic, okay? But now, the child tells you, I had a nightmare last night. I was fearful. I was scared. Something was chasing me. I felt out of control. When those kinds of feelings come up, those are little red flags for us. And those red flags are not to cause us fear or anxiety, but they are just to find out more. What is going on so that my child is feeling this way? What can I do to help him or her understand what is at the basis of that dream? Okay. So one of the biggest things that we need to remember as parents, remember, I'm not a parent, I am an aunt, okay? So I get all of my information from my nieces, from my nephews, and of course now from the people that message me, right, about their kids' dreams, and I talk to them, and we go over their dreams, and we understand what they mean. So that's how I know this stuff, right? It's not because I have children, because I just have two dogs, right? Clucky and Angelita. But anyways, whenever you get a dream from a child, you ask them, what does that make you feel? Now, if it is one of the heavier emotions, we have to remember something that is very critical. The children are going to reflect the feelings of the parents, okay? So let's think about it this way. The parents are here, let's say mom and dad, dad or dad, mom or mom, whatever it is. These are the parents, right? And then here's the child. The parents are giving the energy down towards the child. So if the child is having a nightmare or saying, I'm feeling fearful, I'm feeling whatever during a dream, that's an alert for the parents to be like, okay, what is it that we are doing as parents that are sending this energy down to our child? What is that energy that we're giving? Because whenever a child is having a dream, that is causing them fear or anxiety. We have to remember that one of the possibilities is things that are going on at home, okay? It could simply be that they watched a scary movie last night and so that's in their subconscious and that's coming out in their dreams, right? That could be a possibility. Another possibility could be that there are things going around in the home that we need to acknowledge, and there's nothing wrong with that. It's just simply that us as parents have to be able to be open to that and say, you know what? You know, last night I was arguing with my husband, or I was arguing with my wife, and the child probably overheard, and there goes this dream, right? So just making those connections is incredibly important, because the kids, our children, they're going to really wake us up by these dreams and say, you know, I was having this dream. It gets us thinking, what am I doing to contribute that energy? Because remember, you are connected to your children every single day, and you're living in the same life together, and that energy is being shared. It's that family energy that's being shared. So also something to take into account is when we're talking about these different symbols and different interpretations of your dream, you as a parent, whatever symbol you have, let's say that your child says, I had a dream about this particular monster and it was chasing me, or whatever, a particular image, and you as a parent connect with that image, you're like, oh yeah, I know about that image, and I've talked about that image around my child, and he or she has heard me talk about this image, you can be sure that that image your child is dreaming about is very closely related to the interpretation that you give it. Why? Because you both are living in the same kind of time frame, and you guys are living in the same household, and you guys are sharing this energy together. So if you pay attention to your child's dreams, you are going to be the best person to help them understand what is going on at that subconscious level, right? So that's one thing to take into account. But another thing, for the kids that are watching this video, this video is friendly for adults and children, doesn't matter. We know we have a couple of kid fans here, so that's totally cool. But okay, if you're a child and you're having a nightmare, you're having this fearful thing, one of the questions you should ask yourself is, you know, what happened during this week? What happened during this week that's making me feel like I felt in the dream? You know, did something happen at school? Did I see something and maybe not say anything to the teacher? Because remember, kids, whenever you have a dream about something and it causes you fear or it causes you anxiety, the first thing to ask is, what in my waking life feels similar to this, right? What feels similar to this? And when you find out what feels similar to it, that's when you can really do something about it. And you can tell mom and dad and be like, mom, dad, I had this nightmare, made me feel this way. And you know what? I felt the same way during school when this child said something to this person and I didn't tell the teacher. So apparently those feelings are still being carried around. Okay. So that's all that means. But for adults and for children, that just knowing that is incredibly important, because when you know that, then you can actually do something about it. You can say, okay, those feelings you had in the dream reflect this waking situation. Now we can see what we can do about the situation as a family, okay? And that's something that brings us to another topic too within the dream interpretation for children, is being able to talk about it within your family, having it as part of a regular conversation. I'll tell you a little story. Whenever I was little, sometimes I'd wake up and my family would be, you know, drinking their coffee, doing what they do. And one of us would be like, oh my gosh, I had the weirdest dream last night. And we didn't interpret the dream. We didn't go into detail with the dream like that at all, but we shared our dream. We just said, you know what? That was a weird dream. I had this dream. And then one of my brothers or sisters would be like, oh, that's weird. I had one similar to that the other day. And then they start talking about it. But the cool thing about that is that you start seeing this connection within the family, and you see what I would see was connections in the symbolism, okay? What my sister would see as a particular symbol of a dream, sometimes I would have the same exact one. Same thing with my mom, same thing with my dad. Why? Because we're in this family unit and we're living this life together. So it's very natural that that would happen, right? So the best people to help you interpret your dream and understand what's going on at that subconscious level are the people closest to you. And the even cooler thing about that is that that kind of conversation can connect you all on a very profound level, right? It can create more unity in your family. And that is beautiful, right? So whenever a child is telling you their dream, remember, let's just accept it, as strange or as different as it may be, let's accept it, because when kids are dreaming, their dreams are going to be super creative, super vibrant. And another thing that they can do that a lot of the time adults can't is that their creativity is so immense, right? Because they haven't been put through this same life where we're giving them these various limitations. They're too young for that. They haven't had that many limitations. So in their dream world, they're able to do more. They are able to experiment more. They're able to travel across to different worlds within their dreams. It's absolutely amazing. So when a child is confiding in you and sharing their dream with you, be thankful for it. Listen to their dream. Ask them, what were you feeling during the dream, right? So that way you can understand it, and that way you can understand what is going on with them. Because remember, what your child is dreaming is going to be a reflection of what is going on within that family unit and within their little world. And that can open your eyes to things that you may not know about. So the more that you talk about it with your family, the more that you talk about those kinds of things with your loved ones, the more unity you're going to see in your family. So guys, this week, let's practice that. Let's practice being more conscious of our dreams, and let's share them with our family. Let's have these conversations and see what comes out of it. Let's see what kind of similarities we have. And as you know, if you need help interpreting a particular dream, or if you need help understanding your dream symbol, remember, I can always help guide you in that, but only you will know the true dream language that you have, right? Because we all have a very unique one. So guys, I send you love, unity, and peace this week, and let's work on that, okay? I'll talk to you later. Bye.